my channel, guys. It's RochieRoch, and I am joined by Sophia Mina today.
Hi.
Hello. Thank you for coming on my channel.
Thanks for having me.
You've had a lot going on, haven't you?
Yeah, it's been pretty crazy. So we released Ain't Got Time on the 10th, and yeah, I had to launch a party at the Round House then, and then video dropped that long day. So just like pushing to see how and then I came to the show tonight. So yeah, and then I came back from holiday as well, so I needed the break.
Where did you go on the
break? I went to Barcelona.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. So yeah, so you've had a lot of stuff going on with your music.
Yeah, it's doing pretty well. Like, it's been getting a few like playlists and stuff. We're just trying to push for like the bigger ones now. And just like, yeah, word of mouth, doing more live shows, just like pushing it.
You do quite a lot of performances, don't you?
Yeah, like, well, because I've been told, like, if you really want to be doing it, you need to be doing it. So, yeah, yeah. I'm like, out here trying to be doing this in my life. So I'm doing 5 songs, I'm doing 1 cover, and I'm doing 4 originals, including 8 more times. Just cause I let you come by, don't mean you're gonna stay. No matter what you buy, I still send you on your way. Just cause your car looks alright, I won't be sitting by your side. If you fix up tonight, I still won't be in the right. I ain't got time for it, so I have to say bye to it. You keep texting me all of the time, I can't reply to it. Only 24 hours in the daytime, it's money worth more, can I save? I ain't got time for it.
What is your genre of music? What would you class yourself?
I always say like pop, urban, commercial, but then like to
pop, urban, commercial. I like that.
But then to like, I guess, go into detail, I'd say like my music was like melody wise incredibly influential, like 90s, like early 2000s. But then I really like kind of urban production, so I guess there's like an urban undertone there. And then sometimes certain tracks will have more kind of like R&B melodies if I work with a certain writer. So yeah, I'm kind of just trying to like.
I like that you've got your hands in all different parts. You're not sticking to one genre, you're not limiting yourself, you're kind of out there, and you're actually a big personality.
You are, definitely.
I see your stories, I follow your stories on Instagram. And you seem like a great family when you take to questions as well.
Yes, no, definitely. Like, well, my family's always been there since day. They do a lot for me, they're so supportive. And like, yeah, they just kind of keep me grounded.
It's needed, isn't it?
Yeah, no, 100%. My mum's from Malaysia, but she's Chinese, and my dad's Greek Cypriot. But then I was born here, so like
that is so confusing. Okay, so mum's Malaysian,
yeah.
Dad's Greek Cypriot, yeah. And you was born in England.
Yeah.
Okay, so what would you class yourself in?
So I always say that I'm British because I have British passport. I was born here, but I'm like, yeah, I'm half Chinese, half Greek Cypriot.
Okay.
I guess, yeah, but then like identity crisis is every day.
Oh gosh. Because
it's like, I don't know, growing up, which is a problem. It's like, you never know, like, which
side of my
which side do you fit, like, yeah. Who, like, accepts you, who doesn't. And to be honest with you, like, my whole life, I don't ever feel like I've kind of fully fit in either of them. Don't get me wrong, like, you know, I'm still accepted, but it's just, yeah, it's just something I've dealt with. But then, growing up in the UK, like, all of my friends are like from different backgrounds, so we create our own kind of, iron place, and it's fine.
I love that. You have to create your own. Things can't be based on everybody anymore. I mean, we're in a day and age now where everyone is mixed with everybody, all different races, And I love the fact that, you are doing quite R&B style, but you're also keeping it urban. You seem to have a few dancing style tracks as well.
Yeah, I think because back in the day, I used to top line on a lot of house stuff. Yeah. I do actually love dance music, well, stuff with melody anyway. So yeah, I'm really into like jazz music and stuff like that. But yeah, so it's there. And then obviously when you have singles, most of the time if you have remixes, that tends to push it even more throughout the DJ circuit. So then obviously we end up having like the house remixes and the dancing remixes. So I guess that's where it all kind of comes about.
So yeah, so you're a songwriter as well as a singer.
Yeah.
That's to me, I mean, I'm fascinated by people that can write music. I think that's such an amazing art. How do you create your songs? What comes to you?
Most of the time, when I write, in terms of one day, it'll be something that I've experienced, something that I'm going through. Something who's broken my heart. I'm addicted to heartbreak. Like, just this constant like cycle. It's not good. Don't do it. I'm telling you. But yeah. So that constant quiet stuff like that. Or if I'm writing for somebody else, I'll say like, what are you going through? And like, try and bring out some sort of like authenticity there. And then I'm quite a melody based person, so I'll just come up with melody first, and then some words will come through that. And then I might say, oh, there's this tune I had to update. And I'll say to my producer, can you make a beat similar to that? Then influences. So yeah, it really just depends. Maybe I'll start on keyboard first, I'll start on guitar first, maybe. But most of the time, I prefer working to a beat. Or I'll just come up with melody.
So how has it been for you in the music industry? Do you have quite a big team that helps you with
Okay, so I'm pretty independent, to be honest with you. I don't have a manager, I don't have a label, but I have amazing like friends and mentors in the industry that kind of like help guide me, that I can like talk to. So in terms of like a team, yeah, I have a lot of go-tos, but yeah, not managers.
That's important. I mean, I've spoken to a lot of artists recently, even some quite established artists, and they've said to me that they feel about being independent is probably the better way to go, because it helps you to establish yourself as an artist. You know, for people that like you just mentioned, your friends, they're fully going to be there to make sure that it's, you get the best out of it, do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
rather than having somebody that's a manager that doesn't necessarily know you that well, and also wants to keep you, maybe mold you a little bit.
Yeah, I think it's hard. It's difficult because I feel like I've got to a stage where it would be good to have like management or like a proper full-time team in place, just because it takes a weight off of me in terms of like dealing with stuff, getting pressure, and not having to deal with stuff that I wouldn't want to deal with, like admin, get this promoted to this. It's like,
could just do all of that.
There's a lot that I have to do on my own, where I just want to be in a studio making music, practicing like working on my craft, because I want to be like the best artist I can be. So like, yeah, I'm looking for someone to kind of take that workload off, so I can just focus.
Are you doing everything full time? Are you working as well?
I work part time at Grout House.
Okay.
Like, so yeah, it's my go-to venue. I did a creative project there last year called Wax Lyrical. So it was like spoken word poetry. I actually started doing spoken word from that course. And I gained a lot from that building. So I'm like, oh yeah, if there's anywhere to work, I'll definitely work there.
You sound like such a go-getter. You basically just literally just let me just grab whatever I can. And that's how you have to be. What have you got coming up over the next few months, for the rest of the year?
For the rest of the year, so there's definitely a few more live performances happening. I think I'm actually doing a charity one on the 11th.
Okay.
And I think I might be doing Subdivision next month. Dates to be confirmed. I want to drop another single before the end of the year. So yeah, I've just decided which one to go with.
So do you have like a bunch of singles in your head already? Or have you pre-recorded them?
There's two that are like kind of just sitting there at the moment, and I'm like, is it this one? Is it that one? Do I want to do a remix with that? So I'm kind of just thinking like sound-wise, where to go from A what time.
Okay, thank you so much for spending some time with me today.
Thank you
for coming. We are going to go upstairs and watch your performance. Are you nervous?
Yeah, a little bit.
Are you?
Yeah, well, we had a good soundtrack, and like, we performed with that, like, I performed with the band for the first time today, so I'm just a bit like...
Oh, the first time?
Yeah, so...
I always assume that you get loads of practice time with your bands and all of that.
Yeah, I wish, but no, they're cool, they know what they're doing, but yeah, I just want to go on stage and like, do it now, but no, it'll be cool, I'm excited as well, so it's good now.
I'm excited. I can't wait to meet you soon. Aww, thank you. Thank you so much for coming on the show. I'll just see you again soon. Okay, thank you. Soaking up, let the music take you. Don't let the one good thing to do. Live by your own heartbeat. Oh, John McHale.
Don't say it louder, John McHale.
It's really exotic. It sounds quite exotic.
I'm half French.
Oh, there you go. Half French.
I can't speak a lot of
French. Oh, well, my name's French, Rochelle.
Okay,
yeah. Wonderful.
Okay, let's not go
okay,
too far.
No, it wasn't even like difficult. I know, I'm sorry. So yeah, your performance was amazing. You've got such a strong voice. A lot of range in your voice. How long have you been singing for?
I was 5 when I started.
5?
Yes. Properly started.
So I heard, obviously, when I introduced you, that you used to do some performances for Mandy Jackson in the jungle.
Yeah, I was on
the show.
The West End Charles.
Wow, that must have been phenomenal.
Yeah, it was good. I don't know about 8 months.
8 months. Did that affect your schoolwork or anything?
I just tried to like a little bit of where they could help me on days that
okay.
I wasn't able to do like school because I'd be late.
Yeah.
Because I'll be doing like an evening show.
And then
12 o'clock I'm getting home.
Yeah. Okay.
But it was fine, man. It didn't affect me. I'm still like, I didn't understand why everyone else was fading.
But hey. Since then, have you been working on music for yourself?
I signed with a record, a main film with my lady last year.
Okay.
Probably in October. I released my EP until in November.
Did you say your EP name again?
The Deal.
Okay.
And kind of going inside with the same video.
Oh, right, okay.
And that went number 8 on the R&B Store charts. That went out.
Number 8 on the charts?
Yeah,
that's big.
It was good. I didn't expect it, because I hadn't released anything for 2 years. So I was kind of like shopping. Shopping to labels at the time.
Oh, right, okay.
Manager.
Yeah.
And and then after that, now I'm just touring at schools as well. I've got my last leg of it. After this tour that I'm doing, I had a role in, which is my next single that's coming out on the 27th of September.
Is it another one that moves or is it slow?
It's
one?
It moves.
Okay.
It's a bit more hip hop, actually.
Oh, is it? Thank you so much for coming on. I know it's
a little
short
this
conversation. Thank you so much for
your
perspective. Shout out your socials.
You can find my socials now. The Jean Michael, which is the
J. We'll find it.
It's like everything is just that.
We'll find it. Thank you so much for taking me today. Stage with those big vocals.
Thank you so much.
Even though you had a chest infection.
Yeah.
Wow. So when did you recover?
I'm still recovering, to be fair.
Your voice is absolutely amazing.
Thank you so much.
Honestly,
thank you.
You gave us that goosebumps.
Oh, really?
Yeah. How long have you been singing for?
Since I was 5 years old. Yes. Yeah, so my late grandfather always told me that when they went to the market, I used to go with my grandparents to the market. I used to be on his shoulders. I used to be bellowing out in the market, singing whatever. And always grew up listening to Michael Jackson, Janet Jackson, all the greats, and having my microphone and singing at home. Then I started to take it seriously when I started going to school. By 13, I was writing my songs. So
you're a songwriter as well, and you're a musician.
Yes, I play piano.
That is just like phenomenal.
Thank you.
It's the triple threat, isn't it?
She said quadruple. I think there was something else.
What was that? What's quadruple?
Producer. I do produce.
So you do your beats as well?
Yes. When I'm sitting down at the piano, I'll write something, or I might hear a beat and I'll write something, or I might just feel like creating a music from scratch and be like, okay, what can I do to this? What can I do? Mood of my feelings. So, yeah, it depends. It's a variety. Sometimes I collaborate with other producers on writing.
obviously, I do pull on different artists and influences to try and harness my own craft because I look up to the greats and I try to aspire to be better than I was yesterday. You know what I mean? So, yeah, Wasted came around and I was like, you know what? I think I want to make an EP. I want to put a project together that is very concise and has a nice flow. And so I kind of went with that kind of vibe. So, everything you're going to hear on the EP is kind of that mellow, soulful, jazzy vibe. And then, yeah, I might switch it up a little later.
I like that. Just keep us on our toes.
So can you shout out your social media on Instagram?
Yes, I'm on Instagram. It's Renee Rain Official. Spelled R-E-N-A-E. Rain like the weather. And officially me. So yeah.
I like that. Rain officially her.
Yes. So Renee Rain Official on Instagram. Renee Rain Official on Facebook. I'm on Twitter too. Renee R Official. And YouTube as well is Renee Rain. So just put the Google to work and you'll find me.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
I can't take it anymore.